we'll have our children's story presented by Bea.
Johnny and Lisa came back on the boat to the island. Guess what? All eyes were not on John. All eyes were on Lisa. Something had happened to Lisa. Lisa appeared to be more beautiful. She was energetic. She was vibrant. She was bold. Even her appearance seemed to be more beautiful. And something had happened to Lisa. There was some transformation that took place in the life of Lisa. And everyone was amazed. She was brilliant. She was bright. She was full of energy. And she appeared to be bold and talkative and her presence. It was amazing. They spent the time in the island and they visited with friends and their parents and their loved ones. It was time to go back to live in the island that they came from. And Johnny's best friend, he was puzzled. He was amazed knowing that who Lisa was before and now who Lisa had become. And he wanted to ask Johnny what had happened. What did he do to make Lisa this bold and brave and vibrant? She appeared more beautiful. And Johnny's friend asked Johnny, what happened? What caused Lisa this change? And Johnny said to his friend, every day I told Lisa that she is an 8-cow wife and that she is precious and that she is important and that she is special. And that created in Lisa an inner pressure to be what Johnny was telling her that she was. And that is what created this transformation and this bright outlook in life. And she enjoyed life. The moral of the story is this. There is a process in psychology that's called reciprocity. It's simply this. When you give or do something for someone, it creates in them an inner pressure to give or do something back in return. So that when we tell people that they are beautiful and that they can make it and they're the right person for the job and we tell them things that will uplift them and build their spirit, that creates in them an inner pressure to be that person. Words are very powerful. When you tell somebody that they are dull and that they're ugly and that they're dunce and they can't make it, that makes them depressed. So if we cannot say something good about somebody, let's not say anything bad. Words are powerful. Words can lift us up, can build us up, can encourage us, and can create value in us. God gives us the best words, that we are special in His sight, that we belong to Him. We belong in a palace. We are children of the King. And soon and very soon, Jesus is coming again. He take us to be with Him. John says in Revelation 21, I saw a new heaven and a new earth. There shall be no more sickness and no more pain and no more sorrow. God shall wipe away all tears from our eyes. I want to be in that place when Jesus comes again. Amen?
Amen.
So as we face another day, as we face another week, let's tell others how good they are in the sight of God. Amen? God bless you.
Amen.
Amen. Who wants to pray for us? Who wants to pray for us? Let's bow our heads and close our eyes.
I want to pray for my daddy till he feels better. I love you, Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Jesus loves the children. All children of the world.